Yeah, so what I did, even though we're recording these back to back, and I wanted to point out this illusion real quick, because I think it's a pretty impressive illusion. I did change my shirt to give the impression that it's a different week. I know this breaks it, but the idea is, oh, it's a different week. He has a different shirt on.
Yeah.
It
And
must look different.
yeah, that was a good idea. I did not do that. I should have done that. So I just wear the same clothes for all the weeks.
Or it's either you wore the same clothes all week, or you have a Sunday shirt, which is
Right.
somehow
Exactly.
like weird in its own way. It's like, this is my Sunday shirt.
Exactly. It's my relaxing day shirt.
Yeah.
To dive into what we were talking about last time. And
Yeah.
also, I don't know about you, but the timer that we had last time I thought was really distracting.
It was what it was. I love it. Was two things, amazing, and I loved it. And
Yeah.
second thing, there's a moment in the first video that we recorded. This second video is a reaction just to the first video. It
Right,
sounds like
exactly.
some nonsense we would pull, and it's now some nonsense I want to pull. What's this Yonko LLC week? This week we watch our first video and we react to it. Then the week after that we watch the video we just watched and we watch that again.
Reaction to the reaction, yeah.
Yeah, we're not better than it. Oh shoot. But it was great, and I just pointed at the video at one point because there was a cat on the screen, and I don't know
Yeah.
about you, but if there's a cat on the TV or computer, I have to tell my cat if my cat is around.
Absolutely, of
Like
course,
that's
yeah.
a weird, like this is, oh, hey, this is one of the, this is, you're into this because you're a cat. And then she's like, hey, this is not how my eyes work. This is movement to me.
Yeah, so I chose like a very mundane timer this time
Yeah, no, I think
to contrast with that. So
we'll work it out. I still think we should do the clock behind you. I think that's the
Oh
cool.
yeah. That's actually a really good idea. But, yeah.
Just a big that looking clock behind you would just be the
Yeah.
simplest thing in the world. So we left and we were like, this is what we need to talk about in the next one. And then I went and changed my shirt and my entire brain wiped out.
Yeah, I know. That's the problem with our conversations is that we end up going a lot of tangents, and then we'll go tangents of tangents. A lot of times I think our thread gets lost, but that's okay.
Right.
I don't mind that.
That's why we have guests and it's only 15 minutes. Like
Exactly, yeah.
one of the big reasons it's only 15 minutes is also I just don't need to hear myself rambling for that long. That's
Right.
terrible. I hate that so much.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I think the whole reason we put the timer on was because I think the first two podcasts that we recorded were like 2 hours long.
And zero people listen to
Yeah, exactly. But I think, oh, well, I guess so that, well, by the time this one runs, like Zodiac 2 will have been out for at least a week or two.
yeah.
But at the time that we're recording it, we're about to upload it probably in like 3 or 4 days, I think.
Yeah, it's just downloaded to my computer so I can watch the test reel of it. And I'm very excited. It's interesting, like
Yeah.
Zodiac One or Capricorn, it had fun. Whenever you make something, you always hope it lights the world on fire. Like especially when we work hard on these.
Yeah, we do.
And I think Zodiac One was a success in, but it was a minor success. We had 1,000 views. We've had a couple comments.
Yeah.
I look forward to being able to push a different video now.
Sure.
But it's sometimes like I feel like you make something and then you put it out in the world and you go, I don't know, what do you guys think? And for this one, for me, I feel like a lot of people went, I don't know, and I went, oh, okay, you love it or hate it, and they're like, it's 30 minutes and that's interesting. I was like, is there anything else that like I think it's about this? And I'm like, you, I don't know, maybe. Yes, Andrew, you're saying?
Well, no, it's interesting because I mean I think at least the way that I went into it is like it's a lot of experimental stuff, and most people probably aren't going to be into it, and that's okay, and it was kind of nice going into it with that mentality, because I think we've talked about it before, like a lot of other things that I do in my professional career, it's like geared towards an audience, and it was honestly like really nice just to say, well, okay, maybe some people like it, but it's okay if most people aren't into it, and that's okay.
I I always hope to find the people that like. I don't want to. It's one of the things when I was younger and making art, like I wanted to like piss people off, and like if you either you got it and you loved it or it made you angry, and I no longer have any interest in like upsetting people. Like if you don't want this, I don't want to. I mean, I'll upset you if you have like bad views of people and you don't think certain humans are humans. Then we have a problem. But I don't want to. I don't want to like surprise. It's all screwed up, and I'm saying dark stuff. You didn't. You're gonna walk out. That's a young man's purse. That's a young man's.
Yeah.
You know. That being said, it is. It was fun when taking this piece and sort of just handing it to people and being like, I don't know, you deal with it.
Right.
I'm interested to see how Zodiac 2 fares in comparison to Zodiac 1, because it is like, if you loved the weird dark vibes of Zodiac 1, it's not really there in Zodiac 2. What's also amazing is I haven't watched the video yet. I haven't, like, it's just downloaded. It's over here. In 9 minutes, I'm going to watch the video. I am full of nerves because in 9 minutes, I'm going to be watching this video.
That's kind of interesting. Like, I'm excited to hear, you know, your thoughts about it, because for me, like, as I'm putting it together, you know, we're working on each thing individually. And I think we've talked about this before, but just for our new listeners, the way we put together Zodiac, you know, is that we're passing them back one at a time. And so, you know, this is a process that happens over like 3 months, I think. Right. And so it's very easy by the time we even get to like move 10 or 11, to forget what happened back at move one, you know, and I like that process, you know, because the point is like, we're not like sculpting, we're not making a big sculpture. Mm-hmm. We're making a lot of small sculptures, and we're reacting to what comes before and like, what comes right before, you know, not what comes, but at the same time, like, it's kind of interesting because we also see, as I was putting it together, like, I think subliminally, there are themes that come back both in the art and the music, and it's nice to see how it all connects, even though we're not starting off with like a large sculpture, we're just creating these small sculptures, you know.
Every time you move your hand into the other camera, I get other people are getting nervous. The game of telephone that is Zodiac is it's always shocking to. It's also interesting because Zodiac 1 is now such a complete piece in my head. Like, it exists. I know what the QR code looks like to get to it. Mm-hmm. And it's such a like, and then Zodiac 2 is still in pieces. And in 7 minutes, I'm going to like, for the first time, see what all of those pieces look like in one large line. And I know in Zodiac 1, it was shocking. The things I was saying that came through and didn't come through. There was stuff I thought I was being very clear with that just, I was unsuccessful. And I'm interested to play that game again. It's nice. I think one of the tricks about making art that you can do is to try to make yourself an audience member, if that makes sense. Like, figure out ways to make yourself an audience member. I know.
Yeah, absolutely.
When people work digitally, one of the last things you do a lot of times is you flip it the other direction, because you're so used to seeing it this way. Flipping it the other way gives you an idea of what you're looking at better. Painters will turn their paintings upside down. That's another thing that a lot of people will do. And it's an attempt to like change your, because you've been looking at it one way for so long. If you change your perspective, you see all these things that you don't necessarily see, that you won't see while working on it, because you're just so used to looking at it in that direction.
Right, gotcha.
That happens with faces too, or that's why you see me the way you always see me, but that's a weird thing about Zoom and video stuff is I'm reflected, but I'm not reflected to you.
Right, exactly.
So I think that's one of the things about Zodiac is it's Zodiac is the nicest, when we do Zodiac together, it's the nicest form of critique imaginable to each other, because I'm not saying, oh, this doesn't work, this does work. What I'm saying is, this image is how I feel about this.
Exactly, and yeah.
That's one of the reasons, at least I, and probably you, keep coming back to Zodiac, is its critique with none of, with like a lot less pain.
Yeah.
And it's something I think we've talked about before with Zodiac 1 and 2, is when making art, God, you make it, and you sometimes you get to be the wallpaper, and that's fine, and I'm not complaining. But, like, yeah. God, you just desperately, you're like, will you just look? Just look! Just look!
Right, exactly.
Or listen. Or just, you know, you're just like, just listen. Like, listen, for real, listen. And to have a second, one of the things Yonko LLC is just you and me having a handshake agreement that we look and listen to each other.
Yeah.
And I think that's something we get out of our artist. I think my work has gotten a lot better because someone else is working. I've also slowed down a lot, which I'm a little worried about. We got to do a new Zodiac again.
Yeah. Well, and I think finally, so 11 minutes into it, I think I finally remembered what we were planning to talk about. And this is exactly what it was the idea that we both miss Zodiac.
So. Oh, yeah. I mean, I guess we subliminally talked about how we miss Zodiac and
yeah.
the pure breaks off driving as fast as you can, send stuff back intensity that is Zodiac is an absolute pleasure, because I always think it's interesting that working, at least for me, everyone's like, oh, I hate deadlines. I love deadlines. Deadlines are my favorite, because like it gives me a stopping point, you know. With Liminal Saints, which is a new thing we're working on, it's still kind of in between spaces, but with Liminal Saints, like, they take so long, and the reason they take so long is like it's hard to build into like a vacuum. It's hard to like make stuff and just throw it into space
without
it having a clear destination. What I forget what book it was I was reading, but it was talking about, or maybe I was watching a video. God, I can't tell the difference. That's not good. But it was talking about like how the internet is like dancing with the infinite, because like, theoretically, every time we post one of these, we can reach every single person on YouTube. Theoretically, we won't. Yeah. But like that feeling is, you just keep throwing them into like, and like every time you make the piece of art, you're always like throwing it into this space of like, everybody could see it theoretically. Maybe I'll go viral, and like, you probably won't. And you probably need to curate people who want to see stuff.
Yeah,
and it is. Like every time you like dance with the infinite, this I gotta figure out where this comes from. But you end up walking away bruised. And I also like Zodiac. You know the stones and castle thing, right?
Maybe.
Have I never talked to you about stones and castles?
I don't think so.
Yeah. I don't have enough time to talk. Okay, well, we'll start it, and then I'm just gonna stop, and we're gonna pick it up next time.
Oh, no. Okay.
No, it's good. So when you make art, one of the things you have to do is you have to gather stuff. You make groundworks, and you can gather stuff and make a lot of good groundwork, and that's all your stones, right? Eventually you have to start building a castle. You got to start putting all these stones on top of each other, and it's really easy to just keep getting stones together. Just keep eventually, because like, you can make great stones and you don't have to worry about if those stones latch together, but eventually you have to put them together. Because you want a castle. You don't want a field full of rocks.
Right.
So I think one of the things that Zodiac, whenever it's done, is like, they're castles. And for me, I'm a dude who's collected too many rocks over time. But eventually you have to be like, this is the castle. This is the thing we built. And I think that's the other thing that's so wild about Zodiac, is also when they're done, which is nuts.
Well, and actually, like, going back to the deadlines, like, we have our mini deadlines, but then we've also put this limit on it that it's going to be, you know, the 30 movements and approximately 30 minutes, you know, and so we do have like our own deadlines. And even within all that, we've talked about, like, you know, the sort of rules that we have for ourselves and things like that, you know, as
Oh
well.
yeah.
So it's very much a study, I think, in our own ways that we create and like what works for us. And I would say what works for us individually, but also what works as a partnership, I think. So it's a very interesting study, I think, with both of those things.
Yeah, and I look forward to seeing it in 3 minutes, 3 seconds. Like it's hard. This is an exciting one to do, but it's very hard because, like, oh man, it's ready. It's very personal. We got to figure out where to put it now. We got to show it to people more.
Absolutely, yeah. And I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, me too.